Moat Veper. Another 1,000 rounds behind us. However, stay tuned to the end when we'll be checking the head spacing on this rifle, but at least it went through the 1,000 rounds. You may have a look at this and think, oh my god, something is wrong. Don't be afraid, this is just the magazine with the bolt hold open follower from the weapon stack. But enough with the bullshit talk. Let's start with the cosmetic issues, if any, on this nice rifle. Guys, honestly, at this point, I see absolutely nothing. Today, the temperatures dropped to the teens Fahrenheit. It's like 14 degrees. It's cold, and we had one malfunction. It was related probably to the magazine. I'll have to change the spring in the magazine, but it was failure to feed. So I want to point this out. It was malfunction. Okay. Also, as you can see, we have right now, we went back, I promise you, I will spend more time with that VG6 Epsilon AK brake, and brake is working very nicely. You're always going to have a flames, guys. Guys, are you saying, not guys, guys, are you saying, oh, you know, I see the flames from the fighter brake or any other brakes? Yes, because when you're warming up these rifles to 400, 500 degrees, you're going to have flames, no matter what you have on it. That's just how the metal works, guys. It's physics, okay? But speaking about the cosmetics, I honestly don't see anything, guys. There is nothing. Nothing is happening on the rifle. Pins are staying in. Nothing is working out. So that being said, let's have a look inside the rifle. Let me take off the Goldfucker Annihilator combo. As always, link in the video description. Let me pop that magazine. For the followers, link in the description as well, guys. But let me look inside the dust cover. Nothing happening. Let's pull out that recoil spring, and this is a telescopic recoil spring, as I said before. So far so good. I don't see any marks on the spring other than, you know, classical wear, but everything is holding up nicely here. Let me pull out the bolt carrier and bolt, because this is where the money is, right? And let me start with the bolt. Today we'll start with the bolt, okay? So let me look into the locking lugs, and I don't see anything really bad happening. It's just the classic look. This is what I would expect the bolt looking like after the 3,500 rounds at this point, guys. It is wear, but it is a regular wear. This is how it should look. The front of the system looks very, very good. That extractor claw looks very well, very good too. Let me push the firing pin. As I said, it's a spring-loaded firing pin. And tip looks, it looks like maybe we eat up a little bit of the firing pin. I will try to take a picture. It's going to be difficult because I have to push that tip from the back and push that spring, but I'll do it, and all I will snap the pictures will go from there for you. Other than this, I don't see anything wrong. Maybe, you know, no, I don't see anything wrong on the bolt. Stay here, don't go anywhere. How we are looking inside the bolt carrier, and we have a little bit, just a slight deformation. I mean, this is like really slight deformation, maybe not even deformation, guys. I wouldn't call that deformation. Let me clean this up. Yep, now this is looking perfect. I'm talking about that tail. It's looking very, very nice. The rear of the bolt carrier, everything is good here. There is, you know, it was taking some beating, but it's not flattening down, so that's a very good sign after that round's count. The whole thing is just shitty and dirty, but it's looking good. That piston head is still wobbling, but that's normal. Don't panic, and I don't see any damages on the piston head, and the channel looks perfect, guys. This is how I always want to see the channel on the AK components. This is looking very good. All right, so that's so much for the bolt carrier. This is all looking good. Let me have a look inside. This is that ugly trigger. This thing is just covered with gunk. Oh, guys, at this point, but I'm not going to clean it. Fuck it, we'll roll with it. The trigger hammer is looking good. Trigger is working a little bit better than it was at the beginning. I'm not a big fan of those triggers, but I bitch enough about it, so I'll shut up now until, you know, if we'll have something like snap part of the trigger or something. It is what it is with those triggers, but definitely I would upgrade it, but that's me. When we'll be done with that test, that trigger will be out immediately. How we are looking with the Trunion? Nothing, no marks on the Trunion. You can see nice wear off marks on the bullet guide, but that's normal as well. The Trunion is looking really nice. Let me flip it to the other side. I don't see anything from the back. The mag catch release is working very nicely too. All rivets are staying in place, and how the rivets are looking for the right side, good. On the left side, good. As always, if you guys are seeing something, let me know, because I can miss. I'm just the human, you know. I'm just the human. All is looking good here. The rear Trunion is looking perfectly fine. Let me use the retard strand combined with the technology again. So here we go. I'm using the bolt carrier as a lever to move the lever for the gas tube up. That's kind of cheating. I got the gas tube with the cheese grater on it. Love those guys from the Khyber Customs. Okay, this is all looking good. Nothing wrong. Pirate for you. Arr! And gas tube is looking good. No surprise here, guys. Gas tube is looking good. Gas block. Anything happening inside the gas block? Nope. All perfectly fine. Everything is just dirty. We're monitoring the temperature. Oh, guys, I think the I'll take a picture, but it looks like maybe the handguard is cracking a little bit here. I don't know why would it crack, but I'll take a picture, we'll document it. This is the first time I'm seeing it. No big deal. This is on the part where it's holding the heat shield. So I don't know, I'll just document it, and we'll keep watching it. The bunny ears on the front post are looking good. The front post is looking good, and everything here is looking awesome, guys. Really, no complaints. As you know, I have modified the adapter, M4 stack adapter, and make it fit, and that's Mission First Tactical BMS stock. It's absolutely freaking awesome. I love that combination. It works great. Let me lift the rear leaf. Boy, that thing is all dirty too, from the bottom, but there's no cracks, no nothing. As we know, some rifles have problems with that, but not the Weber. And that's it. Pretty much the beast lives for another 1,000 rounds. We'll continue the test. Stay tuned for the head spacing test. I gotta set up everything and we'll roll the tape. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks for watching. Okay, moment of truth for Weber, 3,500 rounds, and the head spacing test, no-go gauge in place, lift off. And I cannot close it. Okay, I'll pull it and I'll smack it. You should never do that, but I'm doing it for the sake of argument. No, I cannot close the chamber on no-go gauge. One more time. Nope. All good. All good. And Weber lives for another 1,000 rounds.